Hi, and welcome to the Professor's DuBois channel. I'm Professor Corey.
And I'm Professor Victoria. This is our continuation of our General Chemistry 1 video series. Previously, we've talked about elements and compounds and how you can identify them from chemical formulas. Today, we're going to be talking about how chemists will visually represent elements and compounds in something called particle diagrams.
All right, let's get started.
Okay.
There is so much information in a particle diagram, and this right up here, this is a particle diagram. There, oftentimes there's a little square box, and there's these particles inside, or in this case, I've got these spheres that are colored red. So what I look for when I'm looking at a particle diagram is I'm looking at these spheres, and I'm looking at the size and the color. Now notice these are all the same size, and they're all the same color. So I can safely say that this is an element. It's just one element. Could be copper, could be carbon. We don't know. We'd have to have some kind of legend to properly identify it. But I can say that these are all the same, just based on size and color. Now, if I look at the next example down below, I've got these. They're blue. They're the same color, and they're the same size. But notice how they're touching there. And what that means is they're bonded together. And if you remember in our previous lecture, we talked about diatomic elements. So this could be nitrogen, N2, or oxygen, O2. So what we have is we have the same element, but it's combined with itself so that there's two of them. And that's called a diatomic element. Now the last one, the last example, I have the red sphere, and then I have two smaller spheres that are dark. They're black colored. Notice here on either side, this is a compound. This is two or more elements combined in a fixed proportion. Well, the fixed proportion is one red to two black, and notice that makes up this compound. Now, these are all the same, so this is not a mixture. This is a pure substance of a compound.
So each circle represents an individual atom. The box represents kind of the container that they're in. So if these circles fill up the container, then that's representing a gas. So not only is it representing whether or not it's an element or a compound, but what state of matter it's in. So if it fills the space, it's a gas. A liquid is usually represented at the bottom of the container. So it's filling the bottom of the container, but notice how the atoms are random. So it's not a random, it is a random pattern. It's not a crystalline structure that's shown in the very bottom square, which is a solid. So if there's something that's very structured, then that would be the solid. Notice how the solid doesn't even fit the entire bottom of the container. That's kind of a tip off as well. So it represents state.
So we've got a whole series here, and we can interpret what's going on. I'll start with the this upper left. And so I noticed that all of the spheres are the same color and the same size. So I have one element in this case, and notice how they're in the bottom of the container. They're not occupying the entire container. So that means that it's either a liquid or a solid. And the way I can tell that it's a liquid is that it's not very structured. It looks kind of random there. And these liquid molecules can actually flow over one another when they're moving. So this is representing the liquid state, and it's an element, and it's not a diatomic element. Some of them kind of look like they might be. It's a little bit tricky with the liquids, but notice, you know, how I've got one here and one over here that's not touching anything. So it's not a diatomic element. I could call it a monatomic element, just one element in the liquid state.
So the next one looks like we have just the same sphere, same color, same size. So we have one type of atom, but they are going around in twos. So this is a diatomic element. Since it's filling this square, it's a gas. So we have a diatomic element in the gaseous state.
All right, next, moving on down, I'm looking at the spheres, and I see two different sizes and two different colors. So this is going to be a compound. I've got two elements And you can see these are all, every one of them is the same. They're combined in a fixed proportion. It's a compound. Two or more elements combined in a fixed proportion. And this is a one-to-one proportion. And so I know it's a compound. And I also can tell the state it's occupying the entire space of that square. So we say that that is the gas phase. Compound gas phase.
The upper right-hand side looks like we have some different colors in here, different sizes. So we definitely have different atoms. The two yellows are the same size, same color, and they're touching. So that's a diatomic element. The blue circles are just by themselves, but it's just one type of atom. So this is a mixture of two elements. It's also in the gas phase because it fills the container. And I would say that that is a homogeneous mixture. For the mixtures, it would have to be very, very obvious that we'd have all, you know, we have kind of have a section that would have all of the yellows, for example, in one area. Then you could say it would be a heterogeneous. Otherwise, you can kind of assume that it's homogeneous.
All right, moving on. I have blue spheres that seem to be independent. So I have, I would call those elements, and I would say that they're in the gas phase, but I also have the, it looks like a compound here with the red sphere with two smaller spheres. So this is two or more elements. It looks like two elements combined in a fixed proportion. I've got one red to two of those smaller spheres. And this is also in the gas phase. So I have a mixture of gases and two different gases. One of them is an elemental gas and one's a compound. And again, when we have a mixture, we can say whether or not it's heterogeneous or homogeneous. And I would call this homogeneous. With particle diagrams, when you have a heterogeneous mixture, they tend to clump one to one side or the top or the bottom. And it's very obvious. So we'll go with homogeneous mixture.
And the bottom one is a compound. So we have two different colors, fixed proportion, and we're at the bottom of the container. It's not a gas. It's either a liquid or a solid. And since it's a reproducible pattern, I would call that a solid. So compound, pure compound in the solid phase.
Excellent. So, I mean, those are particle diagrams, mm-hmm. and it seems, you know, they seem pretty easy at first, but don't underestimate the particle diagram. There's so much information. At this point, you should be able to look at a particle diagram and say, that's an element or that's a compound. You should be able to tell what state it's in, solid, liquid, or gas, just by looking at it. You should be able to tell if it's a mixture or a pure substance. If it is a mixture, you should be able to tell if it's heterogeneous or homogeneous. So an awful lot of information in a particle diagram. And we're going to be using these later on. We're going to use these to represent chemical reactions, and we'll use these to help balance some chemical reactions as well.
That's right.
So don't underestimate the particle diagram. Stay tuned. Coming up next, we're talking about...
We're going to do... scientific notation. We're going to learn about units and how to convert between the different types of units that we have. So thanks for watching and stay tuned for more. Professor DuBois.
Thanks.